Oh my God! How long have you people been standing here waiting for me to come down to the shop? Holy crap. I'm gonna have to go change something. Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. On today's project, we're gonna be building this great little bed bench. So this is something that sits right at the end of our bed. The idea was that it's more for helping you put your socks on, maybe putting your shoes on, your slippers, but in reality, it is a full-on storage unit for where we put all of our laundered clothes. I mean, let's be really honest about it. So this is a really simple project to do, and the main purpose of this project was to start using up some of that stockpile back here. Obviously, I've got a lot of it. I had some intentions for some of these projects, but in reality, well, we all know how that goes. So what we're looking at in this workbench is actually a mix of species. So the very top, and we'll get a close look at this, or at least as close a look as we possibly can, we have a really nice tiger maple, a really beautiful figured grain here on the top, and I was able to make this from one full piece of wood, so it's a nice big wide piece, and we'll talk about how I milled this using my thickness planer sled. For the rails here, the support rails, this is actually some knotty pine that I have left over, some nice thick pieces, and then the legs themselves are poplar. So this is a hodgepodge project when it comes down to it. But not only does it help me get through that stash, on top of it, I had a chance just to use some really basic joinery to put this together. And that joinery is really more or less just a butt joint. In fact, it's not more or less a butt joint, it is a butt joint. And when we refer to a butt joint, what we're actually talking about is right here, where things come together, they're literally butted up next to each other. But in this case, what we're going to be doing is we're using a modified butt joint. So in other words, we're going to be using a pocket hole joint to pull these things together. So let's go ahead and jump in and talk about getting everything milled up. Of course, where would a video be without the obligatory B-roll of me milling the material to the dimensions we want? So of course, we began over at the jointer, brought material over to the thickness planer, and that got us to the depth that we need for the materials. The next thing, of course, was to actually rip them down to the widths that we wanted. So of course, we did that over here at the table saw. Once we had those dimensions, we then cross-cut them down to the lengths that we wanted. And the easiest way for me to do this was to break out my cross-cut sled, put the material on, make the first cut, and then of course use a stop block to actually bring it down to that final dimension. Now, when it came to dimensioning the tabletop itself, because I'm using one really wide board, I can't do that over at the jointer. I couldn't get that first face flat and then put it on the thickness planer and do the other side. So what I did was, of course, I used my thickness planer jig that I have. And of course, you've seen me use this before, and you can always follow the links over to where we built this and how we use it. But that's what I ended up putting this board on first, since it's one big wide piece, shimmed it up, got it through the thickness planer, was able to get that first face flat, moved this out of the way, ran it through, and that's how we got to the final dimension on this. And of course, like we just talked about, we ran it through the table saw to get it to the length and then the final width that we wanted. So going along with the idea of keeping this project as super simple as possible, even small things like some of these details, I ended up using, well, quite honestly, the easiest thing I could do, which was taking my square and using the 45 degree angle already built into it to lay out this detail line. So the first thing I did was simply figured out where I was going to put it, went ahead and marked it, and then I cut it with my handsaw. Afterwards, what I did to try and make sure everything matched up, and unfortunately I don't have footage for this, is I just kind of clamped the two together, hit it with my block plane to kind of match everything, and it ultimately came out as easy as we can see it is here. So once we had this detail done, the only other detail we really need to add to it is this little notch down here on each one of the legs. And again, just keeping it as simple as possible, because math is definitely not becoming my strong suit when it comes to some of these angles. The way that we ended up determining where and what we need to do for the angle was simply to find the center of the leg and then figure out how high up we want to come, and then just simply match those by figuring out also how wide we wanted the base of the feet to actually be themselves. once we drew those lines in there, I made two attempts to create this notch. The first one, kind of keeping with this theme of, let's keep it super simple, and I'm gonna do some hand saws. And while the notches actually didn't look too bad, the problem was there was a lot of variation in the surface. So I wanted to come in and clean that up. And ultimately what happened was it didn't turn out very well. In fact, actually it was a really, really ugly look to it. So instead, I just kind of redrew those lines to make sure I could get rid of that excess material, broke out the bandsaw, and cut it right through the actual lines itself. And once we had that taken care of, well, this is that final look. All right, so at this point, all of our materials have been milled. We've got them jointed, thickness plane to the dimensions that we want. We've got them now ripped. We've got them cross-cut. We added those little extra details in it just to help give it a little something. It's time to start the assembly process. Now, one thing I like to do before I actually assemble is, wherever possible, I like to go ahead and start to kind of do my pre-finish process. In other words, I want to make sure that everything has a nice smooth surface. I want to make sure that if I'm going to do any sanding, I can take care of the majority of it now, because it's just so much easier to hit some of those details before we assemble the whole thing together. And then it might become an issue getting the sandpaper or the scrapers or whatever we're going to use into those tight areas. So with this particular project, the majority of it I was able to take over to the workbench and actually use my hand planes to surface, also clean up the edges so that they're nice and give some really tight glue lines. Again, since we're doing butt joinery, we want to make sure everything lines right up as it butts right up against each other. With the top itself, again, we're using this highly figured tiger maple that we have here. So we could use a traditional hand plane, maybe with a really high angle on it, to minimize the tear out. But what I ended up doing was simply using my card scrapers to kind of come along the edges and get these, also to work on the surface, and then just really, again, help minimize that tear out that we may experience with this. So once that's done, again, everything is prepared. We're gonna go ahead and start that modified joinery, which again, we're doing a modified butt joint, which is the pocket hole joint. And really where we're gonna do that is on the inside so that we can attach these support rails to the legs. And then we're also gonna do a version that is gonna allow us to attach everything to the surface. So it was just a matter of breaking out the pocket hole joinery, getting everything drilled in place. Once that was done, coming in and starting to drill our screws into position, making sure that we got everything aligned as flat as possible, because the last thing we want is a really rocky bench when it's sitting on our floor. And once that was taken care of, well, here's our bench. That's all there was just the simple modified butt joint. Boy, this is heavy. Sorry about this. And that's it. Literally, that's all there is to this. All right, folks, so I know I keep saying it over and over, but it's a really super simple project that was made even easier by using a very non-complex joinery such as the butt joint. While it was taken one level up because we used pocket hole joinery for that butt joint, it's still as basic, as simple as you can possibly get. And the nice thing, again, with that pocket hole joinery is it will help to minimize the effects of the wood movement, because for certain, especially given the fact that we're using three different species of wood, there might be a little bit more wood movement overall as it goes. But quite honestly, I think with where we place those pocket hole joints, we're not going to have that significant of an issue with this. In fact, as I'm recording this, this has been in our bedroom now well over a year, and we definitely have humidity swings here in Michigan, and there has been zero issues with this. I know one question that's going to come in: how are you going to finish it? That's a great question, and I think I've referred to it before. It's a Vanderbilt household. Who knows? We'll get around to it someday, some year. I don't know. But anyways, though, thanks for popping in, checking out the videos, and until the next time, straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.